dear students, welcome to Gnanajyoti YouTube channel. So today let us learn about the constructions. So today I'm going to teach you two type of construction. One, the question is here, construct a triangle of sides 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm, and then a triangle similar to it whose sides are 2/3 of the corresponding sides of the first triangle. First let us mark the sides of the triangle. So let us construct the triangle with these sides. So 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm. So first I'm going to do is I'm going to construct this triangle. First we'll take 4 cm. So 4 cm, I will call it as x, y. Now what we need to do is, with the help of the compass, we'll cut for 5 cm and 6 cm. So take 5 cm first, keep it on point X and cut an arc. And now we need 6 cm. Take 6 cm with the help of compass, place it on Y and we'll cut this arc. Now let us join them. I'll call it as Z here. So this is triangle XYZ. So this is the first triangle. Now we need to construct another triangle which is corresponding to the first triangle. Okay, so the sides, they have given 2/3. So observe children, the numerator is lesser than the denominator. Therefore the triangle, the corresponding triangle, comes inside the first triangle. Now we'll draw an acute. I have drawn an acute. Now with the help of scale, take 1 unit. I have taken 1 unit and cut into 3 units. Okay, you have to cut this line segment for 3 units. So 1, 2 and 3. So this I'll call it as x1 x2 x3. Now what we'll do, the denominator is 3, so let us join this denominator to Y. Now what we need to do is, so take this and draw an arc like this, the same way without changing any measurement, keep it on X2 and draw a curve like this. Now let us change the measurement, take the measurement of this and keep it on this and cut this curve like this. So now let us join the point. Now we have to do it inside. So again, take compass, place it on Y and draw an arc like this without changing any measurement, keep it on this and draw an arc. Now we'll change the measurement, we'll take this measurement and place it on this point and we'll cut them. Now let us join these. So this I'll call it as Y1 and this I'll call it as Z1. So therefore we can see that there are two triangles. So two corresponding triangles are there. One is triangle XYZ. So triangle XYZ is similar to triangle XY1Z1. Triangle XY1Z1. So this is the way you have to construct the triangle when the numerator is lesser than the denominator. Here, construct an isosceles triangle whose base is 8 cm and altitude 4 cm, and then another triangle whose sides are 1/2 times the corresponding sides of the isosceles triangle. Dear children, you know what is an isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle whose two sides are equal, so that we call it as an isosceles triangle. And another one here, they have given the sides, the corresponding sides, they have given in the mixed fraction. Whenever they give in the mixed fraction, you have to convert into improper fraction. So now let us convert this mixed fraction to improper fraction. So 1/2 we'll get, so 3/2. because 2 ones are 2, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3 upon 2. Okay, the actual thing is 3 upon 2. Now let us start constructing. So it is an isosceles triangle, base the height 8 cm. Okay, so take scale and mark it for 8 cm line segment. So this is the line segment, 8 cm PQ. Now altitude is given. So altitude is given 4 cm. So if they have given altitude, what you have to do is, you have to bisect the line and you have to know the midpoint. Okay, if they have given altitude, we have to know the midpoint. Okay, just to know the midpoint, we'll take like this. Okay, so here I do not take anything downwards, because downwards we don't need anything. So upward I'll take like this. Now we'll mark it for the altitude 4 cm. So with the help of compass, take 4 cm and place at the midpoint and cut for this line. Now let us join them. So this I'll name it as R. So let us join this. So this is an isosceles triangle PQR. Now what we need to do is, we need to construct another corresponding triangle, okay, another similar triangle which is corresponding to the first triangle. Okay, so draw an acute. Okay, I have drawn an acute here. After drawing an acute, so you see that one, the 3 upon 2, which means we need to divide this line into 3 units. So take the compass and take 1 unit in this and cut this line for 3 units. 1, 2, 3. So this I'll name it as P1, P2, P3. So here observe the denominator. The denominator is 2. So always you should keep it in the mind, we have to join the denominator only. Therefore I'm going to join P2 to Q. So let us join P2 and Q. Yeah, now I have joined this. Now what we'll do is, so we'll take an arc, okay, our curve on P2 and placing on P3 with the same measurement, let us draw another arc. Now let us change the measurement. So take this measurement and place it over here and cut it. Yes, so you can see that one, these two are intersecting here. So let us join like this. Okay, now you can see that one, this Q should be extended. So let us extend the line. So now here it is touching here. Now internal part, we have to draw a curve on Q and place it on Q1. So this, let us name it as Q1. So place it on Q1 and draw an arc the same way. Now let us change the measurement and we'll take this measurement and place it on this and cut it. Now let us join. So here it's required extension. So what I'll do, I will extend this line segment PR. So this I'll name it as R1. Therefore now we can see two triangles. One is triangle PQR and another one is triangle PQ1R1. Therefore we can know it as triangle PQR is similar to triangle PQ1R1. So this is the way of constructing when the altitude is given.